Greetings, ladies and gentlemen of the internet, and welcome to Terratech. This is a game I've sort of had my eye on for a long time. I finally decided to pick it up recently, sort of post-Christmas, and I've played it a little bit. Haven't gotten too far. I know there's a lot out there I haven't done yet. but yeah, with all that being said, let's get into it. I guess I should explain probably what Terratech is first. If you're not familiar with Terratech, it's basically a game where you can build your own robots, unlock new technologies, build bigger robots, get different guns. Like, you basically start off as, you know, a robot similar to this, but you can get much bigger things. These are all, like, possible blocks to get and create things with and become a machine of monstrous firepower. he seems to be having a hard time hitting the little guy, but you get the point. Or the idea, anyway. Alright, so we're gonna start a new game. We're gonna have it connected to Twitter. And all that does is allow... I'm not sure if this pulls from, like, followers or something, machines, or if it just allows creations from other people to just be pulled into your game since it's linked to your Twitter account or something. The seed we're gonna be using is Ascension, just because why not? So if you guys want to play on the same world, you can. I mean, you won't see me, but you'll see the same, like, layout and all that stuff. GSO base deployment, unit B57981J is okay. Attention, payload failure on survey mission Alpha. Crash landing imminent, initiate emergency salvage protocol. Brace, brace, brace! That didn't look too fun. And the text was going by too fast for me to read it all. Whew, your cab is a bit banged up, but you made it. This is your cab. Protect it at all costs. Oh, and it's just telling us how to rotate the camera. I already know how to do that, though. Drag a standard block to the back of the cab using the left mouse button. Boop. Nice. Now attach all the wheels to the sides. Alright, so for this tutorial... Well, I can't drag it off now, but you can place the blocks... Like, a block anywhere you see the little white nub with the X in the middle of it, and you can place a block on those, even on the bottom of the cab here. The cab is the sort of heart of your vehicle, I guess. If it gets destroyed, your entire vehicle gets destroyed, so you always want to protect it as much as possible. Even if everything else dies, as long as your cab is alive, you're okay. Just threw the wheels on there. These are the most basic wheels. They're not super good, but they're okay for a small vehicle like us. Basically, the more powerful your wheel is, the more weight it can hold. Or the more weight your vehicle can, have, I guess. I don't know how to explain it, really. But each block has a certain amount of mass, and each wheel can hold a certain amount of mass. So the more blocks you have, the more wheels you're going to want to have for your vehicle. Typically, anyways. You can get really big wheels later on. Alright, we got a little gun. This gun's okay. It can rotate 360 degrees, which is pretty cool, so it can track enemies that, like, try to zoom around you, though it is pretty short range, so it's not the greatest. And then this drill, you can just throw it on the front here. It's not really you can use it as a weapon, but it's more for gathering resources, because it can tear through trees and rocks and stuff a lot quicker than a little gun can. Alright, so you've assembled your basic tech. Now tap B to release the build beam. Boop. And then we have a squirty little vehicle. It can sort of turn almost on a dime. Once we get bigger vehicles, it's not going to be as nimble. Oh, come on, stick your butt down. And uh-oh. Oh, gonna back up from that. Hold up, something's coming in to land nearby. Stay alert. So this is our first enemy. Big Tony. So basically your goal is to destroy the enemy's cab while destroying as little as their parts as possible, because you want to be able to take their bits. Although I think for this tutorial, they're like self-repairing, so you can just take all the pieces and not have to worry about it. So for this, the first thing you're probably going to want to do, and you can build your vehicle however you want, is put a block in front of your cab, because again, you do want to protect it as much as possible. Let's go ahead and throw that on there. Put these wheels on the back. And... there we go. Perfect. Now... this is a gun that just fires straight forward. I mean, it does track a little bit, but it has to be in a, like, 45-degree, like, cone, sort of, where my mouse is there, for it to be able to track. It can also look up and down a little bit, too, but for the most part, it's just a long-range, forward-firing gun. You'll notice this gun in the back here is not firing, unless I do this. You can sort of see the range difference between these two. This is a very short-range gun. But when you get them stacked higher up, it can actually be pretty decent. But I tend to have these guns behind, just the front-firing ones, since these can actually rotate and stuff. If there's an enemy right in front of us, it'll actually like aim up, so it can shoot up and over this gun in the front here. Otherwise, it won't fire at all when we're just firing without a target. Alright, but our first mission is to go find the solar generator, and your quests are always going to be marked by yellow question mark icon things. Mini double drill there. We're going to blow him up since we need more parts. And you can see our tracking gun there is turning, as well as this forward gun. You can see it turning a little bit there. Nope. So that guy actually doesn't have any guns, but the reason why he's firing at us is because the cab actually comes with two very small guns. He's such a small craft that he can actually sort of outturn us, so we kind of have to just walk away from him and hope our little gun can do damage. Oh, okay, we shot off one of his drills, so now he's kind of stuck on his back there. Go ahead and blow him up. Oop, got him. Okay. He didn't really have any weapons, he just had his double drills, so we're just going to throw those on. You can put parts anywhere, like having a drill right there doesn't really do anything unless an enemy were to land basically on top of us. But we can grab it to sell later, which is good. We're going to take the light. And, well, we can't take another drill because literally all of our spots are filled up. So we'll just leave it there. It's not worth a whole lot, but I figure, you know, we can just grab some stuff for the fun of it. And sell it all later. And right now our radar is very limited. We can just sort of see where north is and sort of the general direction where other enemies are. Pretty soon we'll get a quest for a radar that will actually show the distance to enemies and stuff. Actually, I'm just going to take this guy from the back because his guns only face forward. He doesn't have any side or rear facing weapons. So it's definitely in our best interest to try and not get shot. We can hit him though. Hit him with our drill. Yeah, there we go. Alright, he's going down. Oof. Did he have any blocks? No, he just had a rear-facing tire. I'll get rid of this light and just add this gun on. It's not gonna do any good there. We'll actually turn it sideways. Actually, let's do it like this. Let's have a gun facing either way with this one in the front, so that way we have sort of three angles of protection, and if an enemy goes on either side of us, we'll still be able to kind of shoot it. Alright, good, good. Lost radar. Cap seems to have been repaired, even though we haven't been through a repair area. Because when an item is flashing red, that usually means it's damaged and just about to basically explode, so. If our gun turned here, which means that there is an enemy right here. Hey, come here. As long as we can keep up, our little gun can sort of poke away at him. There we go. I want to get that block off the front. No. Okay. And we are able to do that. I'm actually going to redesign our bot real quick. I'm going to take this off the front. Make our bot sort of fatter in the front so we can have more guns facing straight forward. Oops, that's not what I meant to do. I meant to just grab the wheel off. Come on. There we go. And we'll put these all facing forward. Come on, rotate, please. Why can't I rotate this? There we go. Okay. Because you typically just want to have as many guns facing forward as possible, although it is good to cover your sides and back, because enemies will try to go for where they think your guns can shoot the least from. So like, we don't have anything facing backwards other than this gun that can rotate sideways. So enemies will try to get to our sides or our back to try and shoot us. Alright, let's go ahead and throw one of these wheels on the front. Why not? We actually lost a little bit of wheels doing this, but it's fine. It doesn't really matter because our bot's so small. Oops, that's not what I meant to do. I just want to have that drill. I guess that's just going to be uneven. Let's put the wheel in the middle. Alright. Is this... Oh, those are all side wheels. Okay. Yeah, now we have three guns facing forward, so that'll do a lot of damage to any enemy that's sort of directly in front of us. Alright, so here's a solar generator. I probably should have covered that when we went over it. You can attach it to your... Oh, well, I guess we can't right now. But you can attach it to your craft, but it won't expand. It'll only expand when it's rooted onto the ground. And this will provide power to things you attach to it. And this is a solar... or a repair generator. When you attach it to the solar panels, it'll create a repairing field. So if we go into it, you'll see our bot flashes green. That means it's being repaired. Anything that's flashing green is being repaired, so our entire bot had a little bit of damage on it, basically. Yeah, look how much damage we're doing to this guy now. We're able to take him out very quickly. Unfortunately, one of the bot blocks exploded, but that's fine. Alright, let's create another block going backwards. We can have a bit more weight towards the tail. Put another set of wheels on there. Sort of rotate this around, put wheel on either side with a drill in the middle. And we have another gun, so let's just put that facing backwards. And go back into the repair generator, because we did take some damage there. Come on. This thing's a little bit unwieldy to turn, so it's kind of annoying, but it's fine. We're not going to be sticking with this design for too long, because we'll get some bigger and better blocks pretty soon. Later we'll actually be able to attach these repair generators to our craft, but right now they won't do anything because they do require power. So if I were to just like take this off and put it on, it'll say the GSO repair bubble projector. This bubble's not powered, so it does need a source of power, which we do not have yet. So next up, we need to go find our radar, which is over here, as marked by the yellow icon, of course, or the yellow marker with the red icon in the middle. See, it should be just over this hill, not too far away, right? Oh no, it's actually pretty out there. Oh, hopefully it'll stay quiet. Maybe we'll actually, at this point, I guess I do want to find enemies, because I do want more blocks to increase the mass of my vehicle. But we're making pretty good speed. Going down the hills helps, although going up them doesn't. I've actually kind of grown to like these little forward-pointing lasers just because they're so long-range. You can stay, you know, out of range of enemies, basically, and still be able to poke at them and destroy them. So we actually need to destroy this guy because he's holding the radar module that we need. Oh, and it popped. Unfortunately, did not destroy the radar. We actually don't have any space for this. Let's get rid of this gun and just put our radar on there. Now, as you can see, we have an expanded radar in the bottom right. I think you can get better radars, but I'm not 100% sure. I've only played like an hour or two of this game, so there's a lot of stuff I still don't know. This is a very suggestive-shaped craft, but at least the fat end's at the front. Alright, I think that's all we can do for now. Excuse me, sir. If you ever get stuck on anything, you can just press B to activate build mode. And, oh god, it even looks worse with the shadow. And it'll sort of pick you up and move you around a little bit, so you can get yourself unstuck. So now we have to go all the way back. Oh, whoops, I have a spare part open. So we'll go ahead and grab that gun once again and throw it on the back there. Change the order of these. There we go. I prefer to keep these guys, while they do have a very short range, I do prefer to keep them more in the middle of my craft, because again, they can shoot over these guys, but these guys, the straight shooters, can't shoot around the other guns, if that makes any sense. We're definitely gonna have to change the shape of our vehicle pretty soon. Although, we do need a lot of wheels, so it's pretty important. I guess we could just have a very long stick, but then we don't have as many forward-facing guns, so just an awkward-shaped pot is the best for now. This game does have a pretty nice soundtrack. One of the fragments from the blast- oh my god. the speed of this tech sometimes. Destroy that tree to dislodge your battery. And this is how you're able to power things on our vehicles, by getting this battery. Actually, let's use our drill. There we go. Move out of the way. Logs, thank you. Yeah, so we have to pick up the battery. We're gonna get rid of this gun again. See you later, gun. Although, I guess technically, we can make it part of our vehicle. I don't recommend doing this normally, just because you'll be wanting to take the battery off of your vehicle to recharge it. But we can make do for now, so we don't have to leave anything behind. And did I have anything else? No. Okay, we're good. I'm gonna move these back, though. There we go. To give ourselves a bit better rotation capability, because the position of your wheels does matter somewhat. Not a huge amount, though. Now, those guys have a lot of guns, so we're just gonna kind of sit back from a long range and pew-pew with our lasers. They're trying their darndest. That guy's a really wide bot. We should be able to salvage quite a few blocks from this. I want to start focusing on this guy, because I don't want either of them to be too powerful, because otherwise when one pops, we might get destroyed by the one that remains. Okay, so he's down. We're going to try to take this guy down. We outrange him, so it shouldn't be a problem. Okay. Cue the fast forward as I rebuild this bot. I'm actually going to try doing something I've never done before. I've never tried making sort of a broadside bot. I've always sort of made all the guns pointing forward. I'm not sure how this will work, but we'll just pull up next to an enemy and try to just drive around it while firing. I put them on both sides, although we'll try to be firing with our right side as much as possible, just because on the left side we have a radar and a battery, so we have two less guns there. But we still do have four firing that way, so it's not anything to sleep on. We do want to avoid combat for now, though, just because of a lot of our parts are sort of flashing and damaged. So, and let's just scuttle back to base. Alright, get inside that repair bubble. Oh, delicious. That's the stuff. Oh, look at all that repairing. Glorious. And we actually have to defeat several enemies to get their blocks. So what we're gonna do for now is actually it's basically gonna be only a right side bombardment bot, I guess, because we're gonna take a bunch of stuff. We're gonna take all this with us. So yeah, let's put this on the middle so it can hold everything, and throw this on the back. So that way, whenever our battery runs out of power, actually, let's recharge it first all the way. Whenever our battery runs out of power, we can just throw the solar generator down along with our battery and call it good. And now we'll always be getting repairs while we are while we're out in combat and stuff. And I just made that gun facing this way. Actually, I should do that, because I can do that with the battery too. There we go. Yeah, that's a broadside. And I don't know how effective this actually is, but I guess we'll soon see. So you have to defeat two more robots. I want to get some bigger wheels, because right now our bot's feeling pretty stiff just because it's so long and then it's low to the ground, so when you go up and down hills it gets like kind of caught sometimes. It can turn pretty well though. And we don't have to worry too much about taking damage because we do just get repaired instantly, basically. Come on, rotate the camera please. Yeah, there we go. Took off all of his guns. I guess this isn't the best thing ever, because it is hard to sort of keep up with the camera. Although you don't, the camera does, you don't need to actually be able to see the enemy to be shooting at him. But it's because these shots don't lead their targets very well. Oh, there we go. Get out of here, buddy. Okay. Did he drop any actual blocks? I don't think so. Oh well. And the battery's still mostly full. Yeah, as you can see, when we went over that hill, we kind of got stuck for a split second. Alright, let's actually take this enemy right here, because... Well, actually, no, those two are fighting each other, so we'll go after them. Although they are in the middle of the trees. Tiny Shooter and Dirt Rocker. Can we scoot through here? We can sort of fire our way through if we have to. Oh boy. Oh, he got tipped. But the enemies can use the build beam as well to sort of upright themselves and get themselves unstuck. So trying to get him to like fall into a corral or something isn't really viable. Alright. There's the four enemies we needed defeated. Apparently the enemies just need to be defeated in our near us. They don't actually need to be hit by us, because like I said, there were two enemies fighting over here. And we only actually killed one of them. But it counted for the two that we needed. Now we actually have three blocks here, so let's go ahead and throw two of them on. Grab these extra wheels, please. Thank you. Let's see. We can add another pair of guns. Or another gun, I guess. It's not really a pair. So that was the only one. We'll throw this just on the back, so we have it. Alright. So I'm just recharge our battery while we have some downtime. It's not necessarily hurt right now, but it's better to do it and have it fully charged. You don't have to worry about it. Okay, you're good. And now we need to go find the trading station, which is marked over here. And we're probably going to set up our base near that. Well, our first base anyways, because we'll be having to move around the world. We don't want us to get too comfortable somewhere yet. And I'm not sure if resources respawn or not. It doesn't look like it in my experience, so that's another reason why you can't get too comfortable in any single area. Uh-oh, he's attacking from our weak side. And I'm not too worried about taking damage. Ooh, those are big wheels. Okay. Okay, please don't blow up that wheel. Yeah, we got... Oh, we only got three. Thought we were gonna have four. Oh, it's fine. Now that we've found them, we can actually buy them, which is nice. We can actually do that when we get to the trading station up ahead. So our vehicle's a little wonky. We have three big wheels. And so our front's going to be a little bit tilted, but that's okay. And they go a little bit faster and they can hold more weight. I actually have not seen a trading station spawn outside of a desert before. Well, the beginning trading station, anyway. Alright, let's keep going. That's actually a really unfortunate spot. It's like on a steep slope of a hill. That's actually kind of annoying to get to. Oh, we'll be fine. We'll be able to make our own sort of trading station after a while anyways. Scooting on past here. Although there are a ton of like rare resources, it looks like, around here, so we'll be able to make a lot of money pretty soon. And we have... Oh no, just the one quest, okay. Later on you can get missions from different factions, like passively, to do other things. I'm not gonna bother reading all the text now, because it just goes by too quickly, so if you want to read it, you can pause it. Traitor Troll. Alright, we don't have any forward-facing guns. Back up. Keep repairing. Hit him with the broadside. Hell yeah. He actually has a shield generator on him, but no battery to power it. Yeah. Another part of being on the hill. Congratulations, GSO has upgraded your license to Grade 2. The following blocks can now be purchased at the trading station or crafted with GSO Fabricator. And there are other new blocks to discover out there too. So we got 2x1 brick, big wheels similar to ours, but they are placed underneath a block, a light, and a bigger drill. Okay. I'm gonna go pick up the stuff that's rolling away first, though. Hit the brakes. Oh, jeez. No, leave me alone. I have the high ground. Get out of here. Yeah, easy. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy. Here, let me, do like this. There we go. I'm not going to worry about adding more onto our bot for now, because again, we have a pretty heavy setup right now, and I don't want to worry about it until I get bigger blocks. I'm going to charge up both my batteries right now, because they're both almost dead. When you can charge up multiple batteries at the same time, it will take twice as long, or three times as long, or however long to charge them all up, though, because it charges them all at the same time. It doesn't go like 1, 2, so you can't have like one fully charged battery and one empty battery. It just takes the balance of all batteries attached to the system and averages them. So like, actually, if we were to, well, I guess this is a bad example because it's already almost full, but if we had a full battery on our that was charged and an empty one on our craft, and we put the empty one on the charger, it would actually make both of them half full. So it just averages out all the different batteries. Okay. Battery there. And battery there. Cool. Actually, let's go ahead and pop this on there too. Alright. Wait, was there another laser? There's one. Go ahead and throw that on here. So he's got a big old broadside to our right. Alright. We need to purchase a collector. One. Open, please. Oh, I know why I didn't have, or I need to put my solar generator back on here. Derp. Oh, it's fine. We can have one gun facing forwards. Okay, so what we need to get is a collector, which falls under manufacturing blocks, I think. Yeah, here we go. The thimble collector. These can hold 5 items. This transports up to 3 resources, but I'm pretty sure it holds up to 5 items. We'll just grab one of those, so you can see what it's about. It just sticks onto your, oh geez. Oh no. Don't want to get stuck. Yeah, this trading spot's in a really bad spot. My trading station. We'll actually grab a few more, because we can stick them along the side here, and it'll be fine. Let's do one more, why not? We also want to upgrade our wheels. Although we won't have too much money, because I spent them all on the darn collectors, so that was kind of a derp. These are 180 each? Okay, that's not too bad. So let's get as many as we can. Oops. Back here. No. Come here. Okay. Actually, that's kind of dumb, because I'll have to do this anyways. I see that there's more down there, so we'll go grab this pretty soon. Oop. We'll just go ahead and set ourselves down. Go back into build mode and grab some of these. Come on. Physics in this game can be kind of annoying sometimes. Fortunately, our bot doesn't need to be perfectly symmetrical, though. Like, that'll be fine. I don't think there's any more big wheels around here. Does not look like it. Okay, so we need to Defeat the big burner to unlock Geocorp stuff, I guess, which is what we're gonna do. So make sure, yeah, that's already our active mission. And crafty business as well. We have to go find Crafty Mike, but we'll do that afterwards. Oh, we're going on in 30 minutes. So actually, I'm gonna end the episode on that note. So thank you guys for watching as always. Let me know if you want to see more of this series. I definitely want to play it more, but I don't know if I just want to, you know, record it all. Because again, there's a lot of stuff I still haven't done yet, so you can kind of learn with me, I guess. yeah, with all that being said, take care, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace out.